Earth's rotation system is changing, and for the first time ever, experts might have to take away a second from our timekeeping systems, which might seem like a small change, but it's a big deal because this is unprecedented. Let's figure this out together. You know leap years? Well, there are leap seconds. Let me explain. Generally, we measure time in two ways. One way is based on where the sun is in the sky. This is known as mean solar time. One spin is one day. You divide that by 24 hours, you divide those hours by minutes, then seconds, and yada yada. Other way we measure time is international atomic time, using cesium clocks. Very basically, they shove a bunch of cesium into a tube and zap them with microwaves. This causes the atoms to vibrate and start to flip back and forth between two energy states. The cesium clock keeps track of how many times the atoms flip back and forth, because it takes 9,192,631,770 of these flips to fit into one solar second. Since the cesium atoms vibrate at a very specific rate, it doesn't change, so it's a really accurate way to measure time. And in theory, these two ways of telling time should agree. But they don't, because solar time is a bit more fickle. Let me explain. The sun doesn't hit the Earth equally. This is due to a combination of factors like the Earth's shape, tilt, and rotation. Earth's rotation isn't constant. It's been slowing down for thousands of years. And over the years, atomic time tends to fall out of whack with solar time. And since we can't change the rotation of the Earth yet, we can change our clocks. So a leap second is added to the atomic clocks to keep the two in sync. Since 1972, 27 leap seconds have been added. But now Earth's rotation is speeding up instead of slowing down. This is due to a lot of factors, but scientists believe that it's because of unpredictable movements in the molten core. Earth's rotation has been speeding up for about 50 years, but kind of flew under the radar because it had been masked by melting ice at the poles. Why? Think of the classic example of a figure skater spinning. When their arms are tucked in, they spin faster. Arms out, they spin slower. On Earth, when you have a lot of water tucked away in ice at the poles, the Earth turns slightly, slightly faster. But when the ice melts and the water flows out, it slows the Earth, to the point scientists think they might have to delete a second. Like I mentioned earlier, we've added seconds and it's a headache. And we've never had to subtract a second from the clocks before. And that's slightly more complicated for computer systems designed to add time. So yeah, the trend now suggests the need for a negative second, but some are still skeptical, saying that things could change and arguing that Earth's behavior in the long term is challenging and uncertain to say the least. And there are even discussions about dropping leap seconds altogether by 2035. So whatever happens, I guess time will tell.